ends with a promise. And in anticipation for the soon return of Jesus. The coming of Jesus must be what must be preached in churches. The coming of Jesus must be what must be preached in our church gathering. The coming of Jesus must be what must be preached in the home. It is not prosperity. It is not a miracle. It is not financial support. It must be Jesus is coming again. Will you say that amen there? It is the most important issue in the entire world. I'm talking about revelations, blessing sirens. My brothers and sisters, how soon is the soon? How quickly is the quickly? How surely is the surely? Bible says in Matthew 24, verse 36, the Bible met with me, said, but the day that Jesus will come, he said, no one knows. No one knows the hour. Not even angels, nor the Son, but only the Father. So how can we be sure that Jesus is about to come? He has given us the signs. How do you know President Buhari is about to move on the Lagos streets? You hear blazing sirens. You see motor keys. Jesus, because he's a loving God. Jesus, because he's a loving Savior. He wants us to know when his coming is due. We are not the only ones who have been quiet. 2,000 years ago, on the Mount of Olives, the disciples of Jesus asked the same question. And as they went to the Mount of Olives, they asked Jesus the question that all of us might be asking right now. How soon is the soon? How quickly is the quickly? Is it 5 years? Is it 10 years? Is it 20 years? Is it 100 years? Is it 300 years? Or is it 3 years time? So Jesus, in his wisdom, he gave some blueprints. Matthew 24, verse 3. The Bible says, the disciples came to him privately, saying, tell us, when will these things be? And what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? Wait a minute. The coming of Jesus is the end of the world. The coming of Jesus is the end of this world. The coming of Jesus is the end of all things. So the disciples are, we want to know the end of the world, which is your second coming. And Jesus, in Israel, the Israelites believe that their temple will last forever. So Jesus looking at them, down here, watching Jerusalem on Mount Olives, he said unto them, gazing at the incredible edifice, Jesus made a startling statement to the disciples, and he said, Matthew 24, verse 2, do you not see all these? Assuredly I say to you, not one stone shall be left here upon another that shall not be thrown down. Jesus watched down the centuries. He was comparing two events, the destruction of Jerusalem and linking it with the coming of him himself. In other words, Jesus was saying the very things that will happen if you obey, you run away from the destruction of Jerusalem. Those who will be alive when I will come, if they follow, they will also be saved. Let me explain. 70 AD, Jesus prophesied that one day they will destroy the temple in Jerusalem. running around the city. If you are in the guild, don't come home. If you are at the front door, run for your life. Don't think you're gone. Run! The city will be destroyed. Christians who listen, they will say that day, 1.5 million, some historians say, they died in the temple. It is said that blood was flowing and it got to the knee of human beings. He gave a sign. He gave the signs. Could it be the signs he has given concerning the end of this world, which is Revelation's blessing sign things? We ignore them. Jesus gave four categories of events that will happen. He gave us events that will happen in the world of religion. He gave us events that will happen in the world of politics. He gave us events that will happen in the world of nature. He gave us events that will happen in the world of social life. What are these signs? In the world of religion, Jesus was saying something is going to happen. He said, false Christs and false prophets, they will arise. Listen, Matthew 24, verse 24. He says, for false Christs and false prophets, they will rise and they will do what? Can you read with me? He said, they will do what? They will show great war, signs, and what? Wonders. And what leads you to do? Jesus said, the world, before this world will come to an end, we are going to see huge, huge deception. Prophets will arise. They will do great signs. In other words, when someone is casting demons, when someone is doing miracles, it's not a sign that the Holy Spirit is using the person. Will you say an amen to him? He has told truth. Jesus said, if possible, even the elect are those who are called, not just called, those who are chosen to be candidates for heaven. Very godly men and women, good people at heart, people who don't mean evil, they want to worship God. For them, they don't know where a pastor has gone to get his juju or his whatever. They just want to go to heaven. Bible says the deception will be so massive. Even the Bible means what it says and says what it means. You can be deceived. I can be deceived. Our only issue is in the B. I-B-L-E. Will you not say my name again? Wherever you are watching from, you can be deceived. My brother, you can be deceived. My sister, you can be deceived. Even if you are elect, massive exposure. See human beings. Massive. You hear today in the world of religion, in Protestant charismaticism, it's about signs and wonders. It's about miracles. Here in Nigeria, out of the 10 richest ministers, pastors and prophets in the whole world, 5 of them coming from Nigeria. Ladies and gentlemen, see the nonsense in churches today. See the hilarious attempt. Massive deception. Ladies and gentlemen, a disturbing convention of spiritism, occultism, and its contemporary science and wonders movement within Christianity. Satan has changed his status. The days of going to the malams are over. He has brought malams to church. Evil spirit, there is a day. Next week, I'm going to deal with false miracles. Do you believe in faith healing? Look at this pastor in South Africa. have massive crowd. They will deceive many, including those who eat grass at church. This is how low the deception will be. Guess what? Revelation chapter 16, verse 17. He said, he should join me now. He said, and I saw. He said, I did what? No, I did get. I said, I did what? I did get. I said, he did what? I saw. What did he see? Three unclean spirit. And they were like, oh, frogs. They came out of where? The mouth of the dragon. Who is the dragon? I didn't get that. Who is the dragon? Satan. Wait a minute. Three unclean spirits. And they are like frogs. And they came out of the mouth of the dragon. And out of the mouth of the beast. I'll speak about this extensively next week. And out of the mouth of wicked people. Listen carefully. This is the Bible speaking. For they are the spirit of God. Devils. And what are they working? What are they working? Massive deception. Jesus is blowing the alarm. Be warned. Be warned. Be warned. Before the world will come to an end. Massive deception. Massive deception. Massive deception. What will they use? The vehicle that they will use to deceive is miracles. And they are using demonic powers. Black magic. White magic. Blue magic. Yellow magic. Occultic powers. Ladies and gentlemen, they go forth. And guess what? See those who accept them. Those who accept these false prophets, they are the kings of the earth. The presidents. They bow to them. And they go to the leaders of the whole world. Wherever they go, they are embraced. Wherever they go, they are embraced to gather them. What are they doing? Those who follow this false prophet, they are gathering them to the battle of that great day of God Almighty. The book of Revelation unmasks the plan of Satan. He is a wicked guy. Remember, so the great dragon was cast out of, he is a serpent. Why? You can't detect him. So when false miracles are happening, you can't easily detect them. Our only shield is the word of God. Don't believe me. I am not God. Don't believe any pastor. Don't believe any prophet. Is there a person you want to believe? His name is J-E-S-U-S. We will not say it even there. Only Jesus. My brothers and sisters, Matthew 24 verse 11 says, and many, how many? Many false prophets, they shall arrive and they will deceive few people, true or false. How many would they deceive?
Many.
In other words, many Christians will go to hell. In other words, many people going to church are following the wrong leaders. In other words, many people claiming they are following God are not following God. Are you part of those who are following the wrong leaders? Be careful. Be careful. That is why the Bible says First Thessalonians 5:21, proof all things and hold fast to that which is good. Test the spirit. How do you test them? You don't want to test them like the way you test your pepper soup. You test them like you test pepper soup, you will die. Use the word. Then to a friend, tell him where. Use the Bible to try them. Speak to your friend. Shake your friend and say, use the Bible to try them. Tell somebody else. some will experience the war, and others, they will just experience the rumor of the war. Matthew 24, verse 7, for nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famine and pestilence. Listen to me, we have seen in the 20th century was the bloodiest. See people buried. World War One, 20 million people died. World War Two, 50 million people died. Though everyone slime is special, Jesus says this is not your children kind of war. Massive war. Ladies and gentlemen, all around the world, there will be continental war. There will be national war. When you are hearing of war, 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 it's not for granted. God is blowing the siren. He is saying the world is coming to an end. They will try for peace agreement, even including the government of Nigeria and Boko Haram. Boko Haram is an indication that Jesus is coming again. Amen. Listen to the text. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3. It says, when they shall say peace and what? Safety. Then suddenly what will come? Destruction will come upon them. One UN official or leader of the world says, when the pen of peace agreement is still wet on the paper, another war begins on the soil. Bible says never. And when this writing comes upon them, the Bible says, they shall not war escape. Revelation is saying, Jesus coming is the only thing that can end Boko Haram. That can end the war. That can end the pain. No politician, no leader can end wars, rumors of war. They are signs that Jesus is coming again. I love peace. I pray for peace. I desire peace. But the Bible says, it is not just as we wish. There is another sign that we indicate that Jesus is coming again. It's the global war against terrorism. It has rewritten the rules. All the disagreements, all the disarmament, all the treaties between nations will mean nothing. See the Islamic States. Are you aware that people from some developed world, they go to pay these people because they have the raw materials that will be used to produce nuclear warfare? So Islamic States cannot stop now. How I pray they cease. But Jesus says, no, this signs will not come to an end. The Bible gives us the point we currently are. The Bible says, and I quote Revelation chapter 11, verse 8, the nations were angry, and your wrath has come, and the time of the dead that should be judged, and that you should reward your servants, the prophets, and the saints. And listen to this, at a time, people want God to help those who have sacrificed for his word. He says, and those who fear your name shall be small and great, and you shall destroy those who destroy the earth.
Amen.
Listen, Christ will be coming to reward. That is what the text is saying. Whilst he's coming to reward, then the Bible says, destroy those who destroy the earth. At the second coming of Jesus, it will be when the world has capacity to destroy itself. Let me say it differently. Not in the 19th century, we did not have the capacity to destroy the earth. The 20th century, partly we have the capacity. In the 21st century, it is so clear we will destroy this earth. Search us, know, he right. We know with certainty of the statistical truth that if enough of these weapons are made by enough states, some of them are going to blow up through accident, folly, or madness. In fact, at least 10 nations currently have nuclear capacity, including Russia, including Iran, including Iraq, including France and the cohort. Somebody will tell me this world will be destroyed by nuclear warfare. No! The Bible says in Revelation 11 verse 8, at the time the world has capacity to destroy itself. That is the time Jesus will come. My brothers and sisters, I am sure. You see, popular mechanics in Jeremiah 19 and verses posted something. I am sure. You see, the world will not be destroyed in some nuclear holocaust. This world will never be destroyed when men do not have the capacity to destroy it. Jesus says, the sign, you need to know that I am about to end the castle, and the bustle of life is when this world have capacity to destroy itself. Oh, William Ripley was right. After the destruction of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1945, he writes, William Ripley, he says, I am standing on the place when the end of the world began. At the time Hiroshima and Nagasaki were blown away, he understood, maybe directly or indirectly, the prophetic indication that when men have capacity to destroy the world, it means Jesus is on his way. Revelation's blessing, siren. It is something that Jesus is coming again. Luke chapter 21, verse 26. He says, at this time, when men have capacity to destroy themselves, he says, men's heart will be failing them for fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on the earth. Are we not scared of Boko Haram in Nigeria? Are we not in perpetual fear? When you see a stranger, you are almost sure. Men's hearts will be failing them for fear. It's a sign. For the powers of government will shame Jesus. The last book, the last chapter, the last book, and the last verses of the Bible, it says the nuclear wickedness will not wipe out our ways. Take your eyes off the challenges of this world. Take your eyes off sorrow. Take your eyes off pain. Take your eyes off the blessing. Take your eyes off. These are good news, because these stinking, this wicked world is just about to end. Will you not say amen there? Revelation's blessing, siren, he says it will not just be